count on. NBC2 News at 6.
Last year just devastated us. We couldn't go in our yard because of the odor.
Algae is back, found floating in the Caloosahatchee, polluting the water before rainy season even begins. This is one of several photos the Colusa waterkeeper shared on Facebook. The aerial view shows exactly where it's coming in, threads of green weaving through the river.
Our crew spotted algae like this floating near Fort Myers Shores, Olga, and the Franklin Lock. NBC2's Jacqueline Beavis talked to water experts to find out why the blooms are appearing in some areas, but not others.
Reports of potential blue-green algae have been coming into our newsroom for the last couple of weeks. We've checked them all out throughout the last couple of weeks. I can tell you that this that we found today in the Olga area is one of the higher concentrations of what appears to be blue-green algae floating along the surface of the water and even into the water column.
When we came up here to this boat ramp, we saw it here, and it's devastating.
Dean Swafford and his wife won't miss their boat while it's in the shop, especially if the water gets much worse.
With the algae there, we can't go into our backyard. You can't eat any of the fish that you catch, and it's devastating.
We caught what looks like blue-green algae today at the Davis boat ramp near Fort Myers Shores.
Yeah, it's there, and that's where we've had the highest toxin concentrations yet this season was at Davis.
And at a canal nearby, signs of what looks to be the same.
I told my wife, I said, this is going to be a horrible summer.
And it just almost gave me a nauseous feeling that this could happen again this year.
Caloosa waterkeeper John Cassini watches the water closely and daily here at the Franklin Lock, a familiar concern we're seeing.
I just can barely acknowledge that we could have anything like what we had last year.
Compared to last year, Cassini believes these are earlier spottings, and they're also farther west along the Caloosahatchee.
There's always a little bit there, but now we're seeing, you know, relative abundance increase. Didn't expect it this far down in the estuary this early.
And while seeing is believing, there's still some hope that we won't see a repeat of last summer.
It's just an extraordinary thing that happened last year in terms of public health risk.
It's not looking good, and it's just it's disheartening. I hope that we can do something about this.
Areas like this that don't move much are one of the key concerns from scientists. They tell me that's where some of that clumping that we saw last year can happen, of course, similar to last year as well. We're seeing this fluctuate with the winds between the morning and the evening. Reporting in Fort Myers Shores, Jacqueline Beavis, NBC2.